Good morning, boys and girls, and happy Sabbath. Welcome to Sabbath School. So before we start, let's pray. Dear Father in Heaven, Lord, we thank you so much for your Sabbath day. We thank you that we got to have communion last week, Lord. We just ask that we ask your Holy Spirit to be with us as we study today's lesson. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, so first thing we are going to do is have our little song service, so please enjoy.
Shout, praise the Lord. Oh, when those gates are open wide, I'll be sitting by Jesus' side. Gonna sing, I'm gonna shout, praise the Lord. I'm gonna clap, clap, clap. I'm gonna snap, snap, snap. I'm gonna clap, I'm gonna snap. Praise the Lord. For when those gates are open wide, I'll be sitting by Jesus' side. I'm gonna clap, I'm gonna snap, praise the Lord. I'm gonna stomp, stomp, stomp. I'm gonna jump, jump, jump. I'm gonna stomp, I'm gonna jump, praise the Lord. Oh, when those gates are open wide, I'll be sitting by Jesus' side. I'm gonna stomp, I'm gonna jump, praise the Lord. I'm gonna twirl, twirl, twirl. I'm gonna whirl, whirl, whirl. I'm gonna twirl. Praise the Lord.
is so good. God is so good. God is so good. He is so good to me. He cares for me.
Welcome back. Before we continue, I just want to explain to you what is behind me. This is a periodic table of the Bible, or part of it. I will have the whole thing up next week. And for those of you who are actually in my Sabbath school have seen this before. It was here last fall, but it's going to resurrect, so to speak. And it'll just provide just a nice pointer as to where we are in the Bible and some color. So back. Now we're going to talk about our nature nugget. And this week we are going to talk about sheep. In this picture, you'll see that there is a sheep or a lamb sticking its tongue out at you. Now, a lot of people think that sheep can be not so smart, but they actually have quite a bit of intelligence, and all the fun facts I will tell you about will prove otherwise. So certain sheep will actually, they actually have wool that keeps on growing. One sheep, they let its hair grow for months, and I think they're able to make 60 pounds of yarn from it, something like that. It is crazy, crazy, crazy. But if you have 1 pound of sheep's wool, it'll actually make 20 miles of yarn. 20 miles. So think about that. That is about just under 7 football fields, I believe. A lot of yarn. They actually have something really cool. So they have 360 peripheral vision. What that means is, as I am looking at the camera, if a sheep were here, they could see directly behind them. And that is because they have a square lens, and that allows them to see directly behind them without turning their head. So if a predator is coming, they don't have to look behind them, they can just go. Unlike us as humans, we have about 155 degree for a normal healthy person. So I can see up to about, you know, here with my finger. Now, something kind of sad, when sheep are on their back, they actually have a hard time getting up. So the shepherd has to come over and get them off their back. And they can actually get pretty stressed out. So it's quite a process. In another fact, in China, they have the largest sheep population of all places. I mean, I would not have guessed that, but if you go to China, you're more likely to find sheep there. They are herbivores. They eat grass and other plants, and they have 4 chambers in their stomachs, so that makes it much easier for digestion. They also like to stay close to other sheep, and therefore it's easier for shepherds to move them around. Another fun fact, in 1996, Dolly was the first animal to be cloned. She was a sheep, and she was first animal to be cloned. So what that means is that her cell was taken in a lab, and they were able to copy it in a lab, and a whole nother sheep formed. Kind of crazy, but she was the first one. Woodrow Wilson actually used sheep to trim his lawn. They like grass, so that's what he did during his presidency. But the most interesting fun fact of all these, and this is why I believe that sheep are pretty smart, is that they only listen to their master's voice. And I have a video here to show you.
One more time. Sheep only obey their master. Now, this kind of ties into our lesson, because we are going to talk about the sanctuary. And sheep are actually used a couple of different symbols in the Bible. You know, we are sheep, Jesus is our shepherd, but Jesus is also our sacrificial lamb, and that's what we are going to focus on. So here I have a picture of the full sanctuary, but today we will focus mainly on the outer court. And here I have a little model of what the outer court looks like. So first, there's one opening to the whole sanctuary, and that is representative that there is only one way to God, and that is through Jesus. This whole side faces east, so everybody, when they walk in, they had their backs to the rising sun, and that was to avoid worshiping the sun, which was very apparent for pagan worship back then. So sinners would walk in through the opening, and they would be greeted by the priest. Well, not necessarily greeted. And they would come in, and this is where they would repent of their sins. Nowadays, we just go directly to Jesus, so we do not have to go through this whole process. You know, praise God, I'm so thankful that God spared me of living during this time. Over here, we have the altar of burnt offering. And what will happen, and here we have a little lamb, which is the sacrifice, a lamb without blemish, and typically it was a male lamb under a year old. The person would come and they'd put their hands on the head of the lamb, and that would transfer the sin. So they would confess their sins, and then sin would be transferred to the lamb. And they themselves would have to kill the lamb. Now the priest would then try and catch as much of the blood as they could, and they would take it to the holy place. Now that part I will talk about next week when we talk about the holy place. Then the rest of like the fat and kind of the parts that you're not supposed to eat, they would bring to the altar of burnt sacrifice, and they would burn those, and that would be the offering. They have different kinds of offerings. They had a sin offering, they had the tithe offering, a peace offering, they had a grain offering where they'd actually burn grain. I believe they had a wave offering where they'd actually wave. But the main offerings occurred in the morning and evening, and that is supposed to be representative of us now. We're supposed to read our Bible and spend time with God in the morning and the evening to check in with Him. And actually, instead of going and killing an animal, we go and we talk to Him and repent of our sins in the morning and the evening. After that, the priest would actually go to this bronze laver right here, and that was filled with water, very clean, pure water, and they would wash their hands right before they would go into the holy place. What this represents is baptism. So now we are fully immersed in water when we, you know, we accept Jesus, we repent of our sin, and we want to live a whole new life. And so we are submerged under the water, signifying death to old self and a rebirth of a new life in Christ. So that is the entirety of the outer court. So next week, stay tuned. We will talk about the most holy place. But as you can see, the common theme from this whole thing is that Jesus is everything in the sanctuary. He is our sacrificial lamb. He is also our high priest. He is our offering. He is the only way to salvation. He is the one who leads us to baptism. Thank you guys for joining me in Sabbath School. I hope you stay tuned for next week where we learn more about the sanctuary. Let's pray. Dear Father in heaven, we thank you so much that your plan of salvation was laid out for us in the sanctuary so we can learn about it in the Bible, Lord. I just ask that you be with us this week, protect us, lead us in where you want us to go. In Jesus' name, amen.